We said we're going to start, inshallah. I'll be able to start with this. Shaykh Muhammad Nazim Adil Haqqani. Shaykh Muhammad Adil Rabbani. Madadi Rijal Allah. A'inuna bi'unla wa kuna a'unan lana dhullah. Asalahu wa fadlillah. We are speaking, inshallah, with the barakah of our mashayikh. We are not claiming to be ulama or good students, even. We're not claiming to be sheikhs, although we are putting titles, but it is our sheikh called us that, but we don't know if it's done in istidraj to make our egos feel happy and at ease. And because nowadays people without titles, nobody, they ask you here in the West, what is Imam, what do you? So we ask forgiveness. We're putting a disclaimer so people don't think we have accomplished anything or we. But we are sitting with our connection, inshallah, and rabita to our mashayikh. And we are sitting with the intention of honoring and praising Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, reciting his madih. And if we are speaking about something, it's not our words, it's not coming from our minds or opinions, it is from the words of our mashayikh and the words of ulama. So when we're saying we're going to explain the Burdah, it's not from our own pockets that we will do it. We are explaining the Burdah from the sharh of Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad. This is from the book Az-Zubda al-Ra'iqa Sharh al-Burdah. You can find this book by Shaykh Al-Ansari. Allahumma salli wa sallim wa barik alayhi ala Sayyidina Muhammad. So it is one of the grand sheikhs from Egypt, big sheikhs. He did the sharh on the Burdah. Allahumma salli. So we start, inshallah. Zalamtu sunnata man ahya al-zalama ila an ishtakat qadamahu. This is the fasl al-thalith fi madh al-nabi, the third chapter about honoring and praising Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the author, after accusing himself, after in the second chapter and first chapter, after he talks about the pitfalls of the nafs, and after he puts a disclaimer as well, he's saying that he spent his time not doing much good and he's grown old and gray hair without doing much for his akhirah, and after telling us about the sicknesses of the ego and how to handle one's ego in the previous chapters, now he gets to the first chapter, and this is where he actually starts to in the madih of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So he's saying, "Zalamtu sunnata man ahya al-zalama ila an ishtakat qadamahu durra min warami." He starts right off with saying to himself, "You zalamtu sunnata, you have been an oppressor to the sunnah of the one." Means you didn't follow the sunnah of the one. How did he oppress himself? By leaving the sunnah of the one, أَحْيَ الظَّلَامَ إِلَىٰ أَنْ اِشْتَكَتْ قَدَمَاهُ الضُّرَّ مِنْ وَرَمِي. So he, let me mute everyone, so because it does distort. He say, ظَلَمْتُ سُنَّةَ مَنْ أَحْيَ الظَّلَامَ إِلَىٰ أَنْ اِشْتَكَتْ قَدَمَاهُ الضُّرَّ مِنْ وَرَمِي. That the one who made dhalam, darkness, yani made his nighttime alive, until his feet became swollen from standing all night. And we all know from the hadith of the Sahaba about the prayer of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he used to sometimes ahya al-layl, yani he used to make qiyam al-layl all night, and with two rak'ats. One of the companions came to to the masjid, and Prophet's hujurat were in the masjid, his rooms, his house, yani his houses. Hujurat means the rooms. He had one room for this, for each of his wives. And so when people came to the masjid, they would hear him. If they came early at night, they would hear him praying his qiyam. So one of the companions came and he heard Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam praying, and he was just starting Surah Al-Baqarah. We all know Surah Al-Baqarah is 2+ juz of Holy Quran. So he thought he's going to read maybe 50-100 ayats and make ruku'ah. So Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam continued to the end of Surah Al-Baqarah. Then he thought, okay, he's going to finish Surah Al-Baqarah and make ruku'ah. Then he finished Surah Al-Baqarah, he started Surah Ali Umran. And then he said, he was thinking he's not going to finish. He finished Ali Umran. Then he made ruku', and his ruku' was as long as he stood up in Surah Al-Baqarah and Surah Ali Umran. Just the ruku'. We haven't gotten to the sujood. So he used to make the whole night in two rak'ats. He would recite. He would stand in prayer the whole night, until the companion said that he almost did something that's unspeakable. It was his nafs was saying, "This is too much." So he was thinking to leave the prayer before Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam makes salam. So this is your Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So he's saying, "Zalamtu sunnat." You didn't follow the example of your prophets who stood up all night until his feet became swollen. Until Sayyidina Aisha said to him, radiyallahu anha wa ardaha, "Why do you do this to yourself when you have been forgiven? When you have no sins? When you are ma'soom? When you have been granted the maqam al-mahmud? Yani, why are you standing up?" He said, "Afala akunu 'abdan shakura." Should I not be a grateful and thankful servant for all this ata, for all this minna that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted me? Should I not be a grateful servant? Allah, Allah. And this is the first verse of the fasl al-thalith. وَشَدَّ مِنْ سَغَبٍ أَحْشَاءَهُ وَطَوَى تَحْتَ الْحِجَارَةِ كَشْحًا مُتْرَفَ الْأَدَمِ. Washadda means he tied on his stomach. Why did he tie a stone on his stomach? Saqab, min ju'. Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a whole month would pass and no fire was burned, was lit in his house. Means there's no cooking. There's nothing being cooked in his household. And Sayyidina Aisha said, we used to go a month or 2 months sometimes with nothing but al-aswadain. What is al-aswadain? The dates and water, nothing else. Your Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam never, he would eat that dry, hard bread with nothing to dip it in except vinegar or oil, and he never mixed the two. To show you where we are from the Sunnah, from the way of your Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, from his zuhd, from his denial of this dunya. So he used to tie on his stomach, watawa. Tawa ay thana min jildi batnihi tahta al-hijarati lati wada'aha. Means his from the emptiness of his stomach, his skin was folded under the stone. So his soft skin, kashhan mutraf al-adami, was folded under the harshness of the stone on his stomach because of hunger. Allahumma salli wa sallim wa barik ala Sayyidina Muhammad. وَرَاوَدَتْهُ الْجِبَالُ الشُّمُّ مِنْ ذَهَبٍ عَنْ نَفْسِهِ فَأَرَاهَا إِيَّمَا شَمَمِي. and the high mountains, shum high. So this is based on Hadith al-Bukhari that the mountains came to him and said that he was asked if he wants to turn the mountain. Sayyidina Jibreel alayhi salam asked him if he wants, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is asking him, he can turn the mountains for him gold. And he said to Sayyidina Jibreel that I am not interested in this dunya. Allahumma salli wa sallim barik alayhi. وَرَاوَدَتْهُ الْجِبَالُ الشُّمُّ مِنْ ذَهَبٍ عَنْ نَفْسِهِ فَأَرَاهَا أَيَّمَا شَمَمِي. That Sayyidina Jibreel came to him and said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَقُولُ لَكَ أَتُحِبُّ أَنْ أَجْعَلَ هَذِهِ الْجِبَالَ ذَهَبًا وَتَكُونَ مَعَكَ حَيْثُمَا كُنْتَ. Sayyidina Jibreel came to him, this is based on the hadith, this verse, and he says, do you want, that Allah says to you, would you like if I may turn these mountains to you, for you, pure gold, and it will go with you wherever you go. فَأَطْرَقَ سَاعَةً. So سَاعَةً means, doesn't mean an hour, that he reflected for an hour means he reflected for a period of time, doesn't have to be an hour, a particular hour. Then he said, يَا جِبْرِيلْ إِنَّ الدُّنْيَا دَارُ مَنْ لَا دَارَ لَهُ وَمَالُ مَنْ لَا مَالَ لَهُ قَدْ يَجْمَعُهَا مَنْ لَا عَقْلَ لَهُ. فَقَالَ لَهُ جِبْرِيلْ ثَبَّتَكَ اللَّهُ بِالْقَوْلِ الثَّابِتِ يَا مُحَمَّدْ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ. So he reflected for a moment and then he said, O Jibreel, this dunya is the abode of the one who has no abode, and the wealth of the one who has no wealth, and the one who collects it has no mind. Means the abode of the one who has no abode means the abode of the one who has no abode in Akhirah, and the wealth of the one who has no luck in the wealth of Akhirah. And the one who spends his time trying to collect on this dunya is the one who has no mind. مَنْ لَا عَقْلَ لَهُ. Warm water, please. So Sayyidina Jibreel, when he heard that answer from Prophet, he said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made you firm with قول الثابت. The firm saying, yani he gave you thabat, he gave you firmness in your belief to say such a thing, O Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And then the verse following that, وَأَكَّدَتْ زُهْدَهُ فِيهَا ضَرُورَتَهُ إِنَّ الضَّرُورَةَ لَا تَعْدُو عَلَى الْعِصَمِ. And although he was in need, but his zuhd confirmed and affirmed, Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad. Although he was in need, but his zuhd overcame his need and necessity. Inna ad-darurata la ta'du ala al-'isami. That necessity cannot overcome al-'isami, ay la ta'tadi 'alayha. Wal-'isami hiya quwwatun min Allah fi 'abdihi tamna'u min irtikabi shay'. So because his isma was overcame his necessity, because he's ma'soom from Allah to do anything that is not acceptable or not liked by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he chose zuhd when he was given. He said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, these mountains I will turn them into gold for you to be with you in dunya wherever you go. He said, no, not interested, my Lord. Allahumma salli wa sallim wa barik alayhi. وَكَيْفَ تَدْعُو إِلَى الدُّنْيَا ضَرُورَةُ مَنْ لَوْلَاهُ لَمْ تُخْرَجِ الدُّنْيَا مِنَ الْعَدَمِ. And how can dunya, how can dunya be able to entice someone لَوْلَاهُ لَمْ تُخْرَجِ الدُّنْيَا مِنَ الْعَدَمِ. How can dunya, this lowly life, entice or attract someone who is the reason why this dunya came into existence. Sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam. And this is based on, you know, Ahl Sunnah believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created this whole creation, not just this dunya. He created all of creation for Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If it wasn't for you, I wouldn't have created anything, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It's only for you, because and people say hadith da'if, not accepted. The Holy Quran affirms and confirms this. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. Verily, I have the purpose for my creation of ins and jinn is for my ibadah and service. So the purpose, Allah's maqsad from creation is that we know Him and worship Him. Is that His creation? Worship Him. If that is the purpose, the stated aim and purpose of our creation, then who is the one who is the real abd? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, subhana alladhi asra bi'abdihi. Allah called him his abd. Who is the real knower of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Who has been given the knowledge of before and after? Who has traversed the universes and saw all of creation, mulk and malakut? Who knows his Lord like Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? So therefore, if the maqsad is for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be known and worshipped, then Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the reason for it to be created. That's why he's saying, لَوْلَاهُ لَمْ تُخْرَجِ الدُّنْيَا مِنَ الْعَدَمِ. اللهم صلِّ وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله. And then he goes on to say, مُحَمَّدٌ سَيِّدُ الْكَوْنَيْنِ وَالثَّقَلَيْنِ وَالْفَرِيقَيْنِ مِنْ عُرْبٍ وَمِنْ عَجَمٍ. Sayyidina Muhammad is the master of الْكَوْنَيْنِ وَالثَّقَلَيْنِ. كَوْنَيْن means the two existences, the dunya and akhirah. The two things Allah created for two realms, you can say. And thaqalain is ins and jinn. So Muhammad is the master of mulk and malakut, dunya and akhirah. And of the fariqain, wa thaqalain, humans and jinn. Wal fariqain min urubin wa min ajami. And amongst, yani this is Bab, he's just reiterating, of course he's the master of all human beings, but amongst the human beings, he is the master of the Arabs and the non-Arabs. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose him from every time, from the best of the best of the best until he came into this dunya. نبينا الآمر الناهي فلا أحد أبر في قولي لا منه ولا نعمي. That Prophet ﷺ is the one who orders goodness and orders us to stay away from bad things. So our religion is enjoying فلا أحد الله. There is no one in creation more truthful than he. Now they tell you الأمر بالمعروف والنهي عن المنكر. It's true that this religion is between two things, between obeying a prophet's advice to do good or orders, and staying away from what he told us to stay away from. هو الحبيب الذي ترجى شفاعته لكل هول من الأهوال مقتحمين. See, this is what. Why we? One of the reasons why this Burda is recited, that he is the real Habib, he is the real beloved, Habib al-Rahman. And we all know the hadith that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he loves somebody, he tells Jibreel alayhi salam, go and tell all of my creation that I love that one, love that one. So he is beloved to everything, subhanallah, except devils. apologize. My phone is broadcasting and it's ringing at the same time. Astaghfirullah. وَالْحَبِيبُ الَّذِي تُرْجَى شَفَاعَتُهُ لِكُلِّ هَوْلٍ مِّنَ الْأَهْوَالِ مُقْتَحِمِ. The phone was ringing, Ryan. So I think maybe you should put it on. It was ringing, but it's not. I turned it off. I turned the ringer off. Is it still broadcasting on Facebook? والحبيب الذي ترجى شفاعته لكل هول من الأهوال مقتحم. So he is the real beloved for everything that obeys Allah. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for his angels, for his for the animals on earth, in the sea, he is the beloved. And he is the one that his intercession is sought after. For what? The Imam Busayri is saying, لِكُلِّ هَوْلٍ مِّنَ الْأَهْوَالِ. For everything that you fear, everything that that scares you, يُقْتَحِمِ فِي الْخَلْقِ, anything that you may fall in, anything that scares you, any affliction, he is the one whose intercession to fend it off or to take it away is sought, according to Imam Busayri. And he quotes a hadith of Sayyidina Imam al-Nawawi that Prophet ﷺ has five intercessions. Shafa'a al-Uzma, the grand Shafa'a, Yawm al-Mawqif, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when people are waiting to be judged, and Allah, and then the hadith that people go to Sayyidina Adam, and then Sayyidina Nuh, and then Sayyidina Musa, and then Sayyidina, like that, to all the Sayyidina Isa, until he says, until they go to Sayyidina Muhammad, says, I am for that. And his intercession for those, and then his intercession, five different intercessions. Second intercession is for people who enter heaven, wilayati hisab. So a group of people he will intercede for, they will not even be judged. By the intercession of prophets, they will enter heaven, bighayri hisab. Then another group of people, they deserve to enter hellfire, but because of his intercession, they will not enter. And then another group of people, they enter hellfire. They're already judged and sent to hellfire, and they will be taken out because of his intercession. Allah, Allah. And then the last one is that in heaven he will intercede for some people for their ranks to be raised inside heavens. Allahumma ij'alna from those who Prophet's intercession will grant us entrance without hisab, ya Rabb, all of us. دَعَى إِلَى اللَّهِ فَالْمُسْتَمْسِكُونَ بِهِ مُسْتَمْسِكُونَ بِحَبْلٍ غَيْرِ مُنْفَصِمِينَ. That he asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala he called people to their Lord, to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to Islam. فَالْمُسْتَمْسِكُونَ بِهِ مُسْتَمْسِكُونَ بِحَبْلٍ غَيْرِ مُنْفَصِمٍ. So he called people to Allah, but those who held on to Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, because he is حَبْلُ المتين, Sayyidina Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, and Quran, Sayyidina Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم and the Quran are حبل الله المتين. Sayyidina Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, why those who hold on to him will never leave Islam. حبل غير مفصم means they're holding on to a rope. حبل is a rope. So those who hold on to Prophet are holding on to a rope that can never be severed or cut. It can never be cut. Sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi. Allah, Allah. And this is important to know that التعلق بهذا النبي, to be attached to this Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, to be in love with this Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, is عصمة from kufr. is a protection from ending up as in disbelief. So whoever, as the hadith of Prophet ﷺ, ثَلَاثٌ مَنْ كُنَّ فِيهِ وَزَدَ حَلَاوَةَ الْإِيمَانِ, that three people who have three characteristics, if they are found in a person, he will find the sweetness of Iman, that Allah and His Prophet is dearer to him than anything else, that he loves another, his brother, for the sake of Allah, nothing else. And the third one is that he would hate to go back to kufr, as if more than hating to be thrown in fire. So to hold on to Prophet ﷺ, to love him and honor him, is ismah. It makes you safe from leaving your faith or falling back into disbelief, inshallah. فَاقَ النَّبِيِّينَ فِي خَلْقٍ وَفِي خُلُقٍ وَلَمْ يُدَانُوهُ فِي عِلْمٍ وَلَا كَرَامٍ. Then he goes on now to talk about Prophet's maqam, his station amongst the Anbiya. He said he surpassed Anbiya in his khalq, in his physical appearance, and in his khuluq, in his characteristics and manners. وَلَمْ يُدَانُوهُ فِي عِلْمٍ وَلَا كَرَامٍ. And they didn't even come close or near to his knowledge or his generosity. وَكُلُّهُمْ مِنْ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ مُلْتَمِسٌ غَرْفًا مِنَ الْبَحْرِ أَوْ رَشْفًا مِنَ الدِّينِ. And all of the messengers, all of the prophets, they're all at his ocean seeking غَرْفًا مِنَ الْبَحْرِ, to take from the ocean some water or knowledge, أَوْ رَشْفًا مِنَ الدِّيَمِ, or collect some drops of water from the clouds of his rain. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد. وواقفون لديه عند حدهم من نقطة العلم أو من شكلة الحكم. And they are all standing, knowing their limits in his presence, knowing that he is Sayyid al-Khalq, he is the master of all creation. It's even said that all of Anbiya and Rusul are only representatives, that this creation has one Lord, this Lord has one religion, and this and one messenger, one Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And all the Anbiya are his nawab, they are his representatives in their time periods, representative of his messengership and prophethood. So they're all standing in adab at their limits, min nuqtati al-ilmi, from in terms of, you know, they know that their knowledge is only a drop from his knowledge, aw min shaklati al-hikami, or the wisdom that they have is also taken from his ocean of that Allah gave to him of wisdom and knowledge. And the Imam is saying that the intention, the reason why he said that is because that they all know, the messengers and prophets, that everything they've been given of knowledge and wisdom has been granted to Prophet, but they are only taking from that knowledge. فَوَالَّذِي تَمَّ مَعْنَاهُ وَصُورَتُهُ ثُمَّ اصْطَفَاهُ حَبِيبًا بَارِئُ النَّسَمِ. And he is the one whose appearance, whose surah is perfect, whose physical appearance is perfect, and his inner reality is perfect. Tamma ma'na is full perfection. Thumma astafahu, then he ayhtarahu habiban lah. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose him as his habib. Bari'u an-nasami. Then, يعني, Bari'u al-Nasami is the Khaliq of humans, he chose him from his khalq. منزه عن شريك في محاسنه فجوهر الحسن فيه غير منقسم. He has no partners in Sayyidina Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, has no partners in his husn, in his beauty, inner and outer. There's no one, no sharik, no one comes close to his perfection, inner and outer. فجوهر الحسن فيه غير منقسم. The jawhar is the kernel, the essence. The essence of husn, the essence of beauty, the essence of goodness is in him, is not divided, it's perfect. So he is, every good character is perfected in him. He is the only one in creation that Allah has endowed with every goodness to its perfection. The rest of human beings, they may have portions of good character. Some have more than others, some have some, but no one has all husn like Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. دعمت دعته النصارى في نبيهم واحكم بما شئت فيه مدحا واحتكم. And he's saying because people say that we do ghulu. We do ghulu in what? We do ghulu we transgress the limits in honoring and praising Sayyidina Muhammad. Imam Busayri is saying, let's get something clear. That leave only this. Leave that which the Christians have attributed to their Prophet. Yani leave saying about Prophet ﷺ that he is partner with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَحْكُمْ بِمَا شَئْتَ فِيهِ مَدْحًا وَحْتَكِمِ. Then the field is open for you to praise him and honor him. Yani whatever you say after that, as long as you say Muhammadun Abdullahi wa Rasul, as long as you understand that Sayyidina Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم is Allah's abd, is Allah's khalq, is Allah's creation, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then say what you like in praising him. Say what you like in honoring him, and you will not come even close. Whatever you say is not enough. وَحْكُمْ بِمَا شِئْتَ فِيهِ مَدْحًا وَاحْتَكِمِي وَانْسُبْ إِلَى ذَاتِهِ مَا شِئْتَ مِنْ شَرَفٍ وَانْسُبْ إِلَى قَدْرِهِ مَا شِئْتَ مِنْ عِظَمِ. And attribute to his that, to his essence, whatever sharaf, whatever status, whatever honors. Don't hold back. وَانْسُبْ إِلَى قَدْرِهِ مَا شِئْتَ مِنْ عِظَمِ. Al-Qadr, who Allah, qadrihi, and his estimation, as much as you like to give grand estimation of him, it's open also. فَإِنَّ فَضْلَ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ لَيْسَ لَهُ حَدٌ فَيُعَرِبَ عَنْهُ نَاطِقٌ بِفَمْ. The fadl, yani Prophet's magnificence, honor, greatness, there is no one in creation that can give due right to with his tongue, with words, to say something that actually befits Sayyidina Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم's greatness and magnificence is impossible. He's saying, there is no one. All the poets, all the writers, all the thinkers, all they can spend from now to eternity, he said, they cannot come close to giving Prophet his due right, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, by honoring him. So when people complain, oh, the Sufis, they're too much mentioning Prophet. Well, we haven't started. We haven't begun. And whatever the Sufis have done and have said in his honor is not a drop in an ocean of what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given him. That's what the Imam is saying. لو ناسبت قدره آياته عظما أحيا سموه حين يدعى دارس الرمم. If his estimation, this is something the Wahhabis really love, mashallah. Yani if the ayat, Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad. If the signs of his greatness were according to the reality of his greatness, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allowed the signs of the greatness of his Habib to be as great as the reality of his Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sahbihi, you would only have to mention Prophet's name on something dead and it will, or someone dead and he will rise back to life. The one who's already bones, you could say Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on him and he would be back into life. That's yani subhanallah. He's saying something. What means is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not test us because his Prophet is ma'soom. His Prophet is ma'soom from harm. And what is most harmful to Sayyidina Muhammad is not the physical harm, just or the harm of... it is the harm of... he would be more harmed if he's accused, if people say about him something that is not true. Meaning if they claim that he is like Jesus, Christians claimed that he is Lord, that would be more harmful for him. So because of that, Allah did not allow the signs of his greatness to be as great so that people do not become maftoon. Because if they see that's the signs of his greatness, then they might think he is like Lord, or as the Christian said, Son of God. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not allow that. He made the ayat, the signs, much less than his actual qadr, his actual station and state. Allah, Allah. And then he's explaining here, لَمْ يَمْتَحِنَّ بِمَا تَعْيَى الْعُقُولُ بِهِ حِفْصًا عَلَيْنَا فَلَمْ نَرْتَبْ وَلَمْ نَهْمِ. So he's saying, he did not test us with that which our minds would not be able to comprehend. Because he, out of his hirs, his care for us, that we will not be misguided. We will not have doubts. We will not be confused. That's why he is only, and he shows such humility in this world, and even forsakes his rights to be in front of his Sahaba, to be treated with too much grandeur. أحيى الورى فهم معناه فليس يرى في القرب والبعد فيه غير منفحم. All creation have been a'ya, means they reached a point where they gave up. They cannot understand his reality. Creation gave up because فليس يرى في القرب والبعد غير منفحم. So you cannot find anyone near or far that is able to doesn't show his gives up his inability to describe the ma'na of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. كالشمس تظهر للعينين من بعد صغيرة وتكل الطرف من أمامي. He is like the sun. You look at it from far, it looks small. But if you look at it too much, it takes away your eyes. وَتُكِلُّ الطَّرْفَ So from far, imagine, he's saying from far, you look at the sun, it's like, but imagine being right close up to the sun. Would you be able to look at it? وَقَدْ قِيلَ إِنَّهَا اللَّهُمَّ صَلِّ عَلَى سَيِّدِنَا مُحَمَّدٍ. We're going to move on, inshallah, to the next one. وَكَيْفَ يُدْرِكُ فِي الدُّنْيَا حَقِيقَتُهُ قَوْمٌ يَا مُنْتَسَلَّوْ عَنْهُ بِالْحُلُمِ. كَيْفَ, how can people living in this dunya understand his reality? People that are sleeping means people that are heedless, people that are veiled. How can they in this dunya reach to understand his reality? The maximum that they're happy with is to see him in their dreams. But in Akhirah, he's saying the reality of Prophet ﷺ will be showcased to all creation. Allahumma salli wa sallim wa barik alayhi. فَمَبْلَغُ الْعِلْمِ فِيهِ أَنَّهُ بَشَرٌ وَأَنَّهُ خَيْرُ خَلْقِ اللَّهِ كُلِّهِمِ. This is the verse that Prophet ﷺ, that Sayyidina Imam Busayri got stuck in. فَمَبْلَغُ الْعِلْمِ فِيهِ أَنَّهُ بَشَرٌ فَمَبْلَغُ الْعِلْمِ فِيهِ أَنَّهُ بَشَرٌ. And Prophet ﷺ came to him in his dream and he told him the remainder of the verse. وَأَنَّهُ خَيْرُ خَلْقِ اللَّهِ كُلِّهِمْ. He says the maximum knowledge we can have about Sayyidina Muhammad ﷺ as human beings in this world is that he is a human being, but he is better than all of human beings, of all creation. He's the best of all creation. Allah. وكل آية أتى الكرام بها فإنما اتصلت من نوره بهم. Every miracle that prophets and messengers came before him with, it was from his light, taken from his light. فإنه شمس فضل هم كواكبها يظهرن أنوارها للناس في الظلم. He is like the sun in terms of his fadl, in terms of his benefit. He is like the sun, and they are like the planets around it. The messengers are like the planets. They reflect some of that sunlight onto people, each according to who he was sent to. أكرم بخلق نبي زانه خلق بالحسن مشتمل بالبشر متسم. He's saying that أكرم بخلقي, means be astonished with the creation of a Nabi, of a Prophet ﷺ. زَانَهُ خُلُقٌ, was dressed with a beautiful خُلُق, character. بِالْحُسْنِ مُشْتَمِلٍ بِالْبِشْرِ مُتَّسِمٍ, with beauty. زَانَهُ خُلُقٌ means he was beautified by traits and characters of beauty, which includes beauty. بِالْبِشْرِ مُتَّسِمِ, and he's always smiling. Allah, Allah. كَالزَّهْرِ فِي تَرَفٍ وَالْبَدْرِ فِي شَرَفٍ وَالْبَحْرِ فِي كَرَمٍ وَالدَّهْرِ فِي هِمَمِ. كَالزَّهْرِ, he is like the zahr, the rose, fi tarafin, And he like, if you touch the petals of plant of the flowers, but how soft, he is like that. And Sayyidina Anas radiallahu anhu قال ما مسست حريرا ولا ديباجا أريا من كف النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. I've never touched harir silk or dibaj alien min kaff an-nabi, like softer than Prophet's palm. Kal badri kazari fi tarafin wal badri, badri full moon in honor, it means there's nothing above the full moon in terms of perfection, in his sharaf, in his honor. Wal bahri fi karamin, he is like the ocean in his generosity. Wal dahri fi himami, and he is like time. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad. He is like time when he intends to do something. You know, like time is unstoppable. He is also unstoppable with his azm, with his himma, with his once he starts to do something, that's it. وكأنه فرد من جلالته في عسكر حين تلقاه وفي حشم. He's saying now, when he is one person, but if you see him from his majesty, as if he has a whole army behind him. كأنما اللؤلؤ المكنون في صدف من معدني منطق منه مبتسم. لؤلؤ, he's saying he is his when he speaks, from his, a light from his mouth comes like lu'lu, like pearls. When he smiles, لطيبا يعدل تربا ضم أعظمه طوبى لمنتشق منه وملتثم. He's saying there is no perfume that can compete with even the dust from the smell of the dust from his grave, even the dust where he is, where Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam grave is more beautiful to smell. And he's saying Tuba, glad tidings for those who smell the smell of that soil. Allahumma salli wa sallim wa barik ala Sayyidina Muhammad. So this is the third chapter. Alhamdulillah, we did the I hope it took a little bit longer than I thought it will, but we have almost an hour here in Toronto to inshallah read we'll try to read the Burdah. And I know if you are not reading the Burdah with us, make salawat as you're listening. And if you can read along, I know I read quick, and we because of the shortness of time, we are not stopping on every verse and making salawat. But if you are online and you're make salawat, inshallah, as much as you can. مولاي صلي وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كلهم. أمن تذكر جيران بذي سلم ماذا استدام عن جرام مقلة بدمي. أم هبت الريح من تلك قاظمة وأومض البرق في الظلماء من إضمي. فما لعينيك إن قلت اكف فاهمتها وما لقلبك إن قلت استفيق. يا همي مولاي صلي وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كلهم. أيحسب الصب أن الحب منكتم ما بين منسجم منه ومضطرم. لولا الهوى لم ترق دمعا على طلل ولا أريق تلذكر البان والعلم. فكيف تنكر حبا بعدما شهدت به عليك عدول الدمع والسقم مولاي صلي وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كلهم وأثبت الوجد خطي عبرة وضنا مثل البهار على خديك والعلم نعم سرى طيف من أهوى فأرقني والحب يعترض اللذات بالألم يا لائمي بالهوى العذر معذرة مني إليك ولو أنصفت لم تلومي عادتك حالي لا سري بمستتر عن الوشاة ولا دائب منحسم مولاي صلي وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كلهم محطني النصح لكن لست أسمعه إن المحب عن العذاب في صنمي إني تعمت نصيح الشيب في عذر والشيب أبعد في نصح عن التهم مولاي صلي وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كلهم فإن أمارتي بالسوء ما اتعظت من جالها بنذير الشيب والهرم ولا أعدت من الفعل الجميل قرى ضيف ألم برأس غير محتشم مولاي صلي وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كلهم لو كنت أعلم أني ما أوقره كتمت سرا بدا لي منه بالكتم من لي برد جماح من غوايتها كما يرد جماح الخيل باللجم فلا ترم بالمعاصي كسر شهوتها إن الطعام يقوي شهوة النهم والنفس كالطفل إن تهمله شب على حب الرضاع وإن تفطمه ينفطم فاصرف هواها وحاذر أن توليه إن الهوى ما تولى يصمئ أو يصم مولاي صلي وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كلهم مولاي صلي وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كلهم ورعايا وهي في الأعمال سائمة وإن هي استحلت المرعى فلا تسمي كم حسنات لذة للمرء قاتلة من حيث لم يدري أن السم في الدسم واخشى الدسائس من جوع ومن شبع فربما أخمصة شر من التخم مولاي صلي وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كلهم واستفرغي الدمع من عين قد امتلأت من المحارم والزم حمية الندم وخالف النفس والشيطان وعصيما وإنهما محضاك النصح فالتائم مولاي صلي وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كلهم ولا تطع منهما خصما ولا حكما فأنت تعرف كيد الخصم والحكم استغفر الله من قول بلا عمل لقد نسبت به نسلا لذي عقم أمرتك الخير لكن ما أتمرت به وما استقمت فما قولي لك استقم ولا تزاودت قبل الموت نافلة ولم أصلي سوى فرض ولم أصم مولاي صلي وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كلهم
إن شاء الله we to keep
your heart and attention with us. We're going to try something, inshallah, we're going to try to play some deaf in the background. You let us know.
صلي وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبي.
بك خير الخلق كله وانسوي إلى ذاته ما شئت من شرف وانسوي إلى قدره ما شئت من عظام مولاي صل وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كله فإن فضل رسول الله ليس له فإن فضل رسول الله ليس له حد فيعرب عنه ناطقون بفم مولاي صل وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كله لو نسبت قدره آياته عظاما أحيى اسمه حين يدعى دارس الرمام مولاي صل وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كله لم يمتحن بما تعيا العقول به حرصا علينا فلم نرتب ولم ناهب مولاي صل وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كله أعيا الورى فاعموا معناه فليس يرى في القرب والبعد فيه غير منبحم مولاي صل وسلم على حبيبك خير الخلق كله كالشمس تظهر للعينين من بعود صغيرة وتكل الطرف من أمام مولاي صل وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كله وكيف يدرك في الدنيا حقيقته قوم نيام تسلوا عنه بالحلم مولاي صل وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كله فمبلغ العلم فيه أنه بشر وأنه خير خلق الله كلهم مولاي صل وسلم دائما على حبيبك خير الخلق كله وكل آي أتى الرسل الكرام بها فإنما اتصلت من نوره بهم مولاي صل وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كله فإنه شمس فضل هم كواكب ويظهرن أنوار للناس في الظلم مولاي صل وسلم دائما بك خير الخلق كلهم أكرم بخلق نبي زنه خلق بالحسن مشتمل بالبشر متسم مولاي صل وسلم دائما على حبيبك خير الخلق كلهم كالزهر في طرف والبدر في شرف والبحر في كرام والدار في همم كأنه هو فرد من جلالته في عسكرين حين تلقاه وفي حشم مولاي صل وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كلهم كأنما اللؤلؤ المكنون في صدف من معدن منطق منه ومبتسم يطيب يعدل تربا ضم أعظمه لطيب يعدل تربا ضم أعظمه طوبا لمنتشق منه وملتثم مولاي صل وسلم دائما أبا على حبيبك خير الخلق كلهم. So this is the third chapter that we just explained. Let me see. Can you tell me in the chat if the drums are okay, or we do it without the drums?
It's brilliant, Sheikh.
Alhamdulillah. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عدد من صلى عليه وصلي على سيدنا محمد عدد من لم يصلي عليه. We're going to start the fourth chapter. It's about his birth, inshallah. على حبيبك خير الخلق كله مولاي صلي وسلم دائما أبا. Let's try the Muhammad. Yeah, this one. مولاي صلي وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كلهم مولاي صلي وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كلهم أبنا مولد عن طيب عنصري يا طيب مبتدا منه ومختتم مولاي
الشياطين يقفوا
إثرامون هزيمي مولاي صلي وسلم دائما أبا على حبيبك خير الخلق كله كأنه مأربا أبطال أبرهة وعسكرون بالحصى من رحتيه رومي مولاي صلي وسلم دائما أبا على حبيبك خير الخلق كله نبذا به بعد تسبيح بباطنه نبذ المسبح من أحشاء ملتقيم مولاي صلي وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كله. داءت لدعوتي الأشجار ساجدة تمشي إلي على ساق بلا قدم كأنما سطرت سطرا لما كتبت فروعها من بديع الخط باللقم مثل الغمامة أنا سار سائرة تقي حر وطيس للهجير حمي أقسمت بالقمر المنشق إن له من قلبه نسبة مبرورة القسم وما حوى الغار من خير ومن كرم وكل طرف من الكفار عنه عمي فالصدق في الغار والصديق لم يرما فالصدق في الغار والصديق لم يرما وهم يقولون ما بالغار من أري ظنوا الحمام وظنوا العنكبوت على خير البرية لم تنسج ولم تحوم وقاية الله أغنت عن مضاعفة من الدروع وعن آل من الأطم ما سامني الدار ضيما واستجرت به إلا ونلت جوارا منه لم يضم ولا التمست غنى الدارين من يده إلا استلمت الندى من خير مستلم لا تنكر الوحي لا تنكر الوحي من رؤياه إن له قلبا متى نامت العينان لم ينم وذاك حين بلوغ من نبوته فليس ينكر فيه حال محتلم تبارك الله ما وحي ما وحي تبارك الله ما وحي بمكتسب ولا نبي على غيب بمتهم كما برأت وصبا باللمس راحته وأطلقت إربا من ربقة اللمم وأحيت السنة الشاباء دعوته حتى حكت غرة في الآصر الدوم بعارض جاد أو خلت البطاح بها سيب من اليم أو سيل من العرم مولاي صلي وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كلهم دعني ووصفي آيات له ظهرت ظهور نار القرى ليلا على علم فالدر يزداد حسنا وهو منتظم وليس ينقص قدرا غير منتظم فما تطاول آمال المديح إلى ما في من كرم الأخلاق والشيم آيات حق من الرحمن محدثة قديمة صفة الموصوف بالقدم لم تقترن بزمان وهي تخبرنا عن المعاد وعن عاد وعن إرم دامت الدن دامت لدنيا ففاقت كل معجزة من النبيين إذ جاءت ولم تدم محكمات فما تبقين من شبو لذي شقاق وما تبغين من حكم ما حوربت قط إلا عاد من حرب أعدى الأعادي إليها ملقي السلم ردت بلاغتها دعوى معارضيا رد الغيور يد الجاني عن الحرم لا معان كموج البحر في مدد وفوق جوهره في الحسن والقيام مولاي صل وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كلهم فما تعد ولا تحصى عجائبها ولا تسام على الإكثار بالشأم قرت بها عين قارئة فقلت له لقد فرت بحبل الله فاعتصمي إن تتلوى حيفة من حر نار لظى أطفأت حار لظى من وردها الشبم كأنها الحوض تبيض الوجوه به من العصاة وقد جاءوك الحمم وكالصراط وكالميزان معادلة فالقسط من غيرها في الناس لم يقم لا تعجبا لحسود راح ينكرها تجاهلا وهو عين الحاذق الفهم قد تنكر العين ضوء الشمس من رمد وينكر الفم طعم الماء من سقم مولاي صل وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كلهم. يا خير من يمم العافون ساحته سعيا وفوق متون الأينق الرسل مولاي صل وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كله ومن هو الآية الكبرى لمعتبر ومن هو نعمة العظمى لمغتنم مولاي صل وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كله سريت من حرام ليلا إلى حرام كما سرى البدر في داج من الظلام مولاي صل وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كله وبالتترقى إلى أن نلت منزلة من طاب قوسين لم تدرك ولم تران مولاي صل وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كله وقدماتك جميع الأنبياء بها والرسل تقديم مخدوم على خدم مولاي صل وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كله وأنت تخترق السبع الطباق بهم في موكب كنت فيه صاحب العالم مولاي صل وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كله حتى إذا لم تدع شأوا لمستبق من الدنو ولا مرقى لمستنم مولاي صل وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كله خفضت كل مقام بالإضافة إذ نوديت برفع مثل المرقى أفراد العالم مولاي صل وسلم على حبيبك خير الخلق كله كيما تفوز بوصل أي مستتر عن العيون وسر أي مكتتم مولاي صل وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كله فحست كل فخار غير مشترك وجست كل مقام غير مزدح مولاي صل وسلم دائما أبد على حبيبك خير الخلق كله وجل مقدار ما ولت من رتب وعز إدراك ما ولت من نعم مولاي صل وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كله بشرى لنا معشر الإسلام إن لنا من العناية ركنا غير منهدم مولاي صل وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كله لما دعا الله دعينا لطاعته بأكرم الرسل كنا أكرم الأمم لما دعا دعينا لما دعا الله دعينا لطاعته بأكرم الرسل كنا أكرم الأمم مولاي صل وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كله رأت قلوب العدام باه بعثته كنبأة أشفلت غفلا من الغنم ما زال يلقاهم في كل معترك حتى حكوا بالقنا لحما على وضم مولاي صل وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كله ودوا الفرار فكادوا يغمطون بي أشلاء شالت مع العقبان والرخام تمضي الليالي ولا يدرون عدة ما لم تكن من ليالي الأشهر الحروب كأنما الدين ضيف حل ساحتهم بكل قارم إلى لحم العدا قارم مولاي صل وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك كله بيجنوب بحر خميس فوق سابحة يرمي بموج أبطال ملتطي من كل منتدب لله محتسب يسطو بمستأصل للكفر مصطلم مولاي صل وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك غير الخلق كلهم حتى غدات ملة الإسلام وهي بهم من بعد غربتها موصولة الرحيم مكفولة أبدا منهم بخير أب وخير بعل فلم تيتم ولم تئم مولاي صل وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كلهم هم الجبال فسل عنهم مصادمهم ماذا رأى منه في كل مصطدم وسل حنينا وسل بدرا وسل أحودا فصول حتف لهم أدهى من الوخام مولاي صل وسلم دائما تبات على حبيبك خير الخلق كله المصدر البيض حمرا بعدما وردت من العدا كل مسود من اللمام والكاتبين بسور الخط ما تركت أقلامهم حرف جسم غير منعدم مولاي صل وسلم دائما على حبيبك خير الخلق كله شاك السلاح لهم سيما تميزهم والورد يمتاز بالسيما عن السلام عودي إليك رياح النصر نشره فتحسب الزهر في الأكمام كل كم كأنهم في ظهور الخيط نبت روبا من شدة الحزم لا من شدة الحزوم مولاي صل وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كله صارت قلوب العيدى من بأسهم فرقا فما تفرق بين البام والبهم ومن تكن برسول الله نصرته إن تلقه الأسد في أجامها تجم مولاي صل وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كله ولن ترى من ولي غير منتصر به ولا من عدو غير منقسم أحل أمة في حرز ملتي كالليث حل مع الأشبال في أنم مولاي صل وسلم دائما أمان على حبيبك خير الخلق كن كم جدلت كلمات الله من جدل فيه وكم خصم البرهان من خصم كفك بالعلم بالأم معجزة في الجاهلية والتأديب في اليتم مولاي صل وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كلهم خدمته بمديح أستقيل به ذنوب عمر مضى في الشعر والخدم قدمت بمديح أستقيل به ذنوب عمر مضى في الشعر والخدم إذ قلداني ما تخشى ما تخشى عواقب كأنني بهما هدي من النعم أطعت غي الصبا في الحالتين وما حصلت إلا على الآثام والندم فيا خسارة نفس في تجارتها لم تشتري الدين بالدنيا ولم تسم ومن يبع آجلا منه بعاجل يبن له الغبن في بيع وفي سلم إن آتي ذنبا فما عهدي بمنتقد من النبي ولا حبلي بمنصرم فإن لي ذمة منه بتسميتي محمدا وهو أوفى الخلق بالذمم إن لم يكن في معادي آخذا بيدي فضلا وإلا فقل يا زلة القدم حاشاه أن يحرم الراجي مكارمه أو يرجع الجار منه غير محترم ومنذ ألزمت أفكاري مدائحا وجدت لخلاصي غير خير ملتزم ولن يفوت الغنى منه يدا تربت إن الحياة ينبت الأزهار في الأكم ولم أرد زهرة الدنيا التي اقتطفت يدا زهير بما أثنى على هرمي مولاي صلي وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كلهم This is the last chapter inshallah. اسمه قاسم من أعظم القاسم يا ربي بالمصطفى بلغ مقاصدنا واغفر لنا يا واسع الكرم واغفر لنا ما مضى يا واسع الكرم اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد في الأولين وصل على سيدنا محمد في الآخرين اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد بعد الله في علم الله صلاة دائمة بدوام ملك الله اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد طب القلوب ودوائها وعافية الأبدان وشفائها ونور الأبصار وضيائها اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد صلاة تنجينا بها من جميع الأهوال والآفات تغيرنا بها جميع الحاجات تطهرنا بها من جميع السيئات وعلم عندك أعلى الدرجات تبلغنا بأقصى الغايات من جميع الخيرات في الحياة وبعد الممات يا ربي بالمصطفى بلغ مقاصدنا واغفر لنا ما مضى يا واسع الكرم بجاه من بيته في طيبة حرم واسمه قسم من أعظم القسم يا الله 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 جئنا إلى باب حبيبك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم يا رب وأنت الذي قلت لو أنهم وأنت الذي قلت في كتابك المنزل على لسان نبيك المرسل ولو أنهم إذ ظلموا أنفسهم جاءوك فاستغفروا الله واستغفر لهم الرسول لوجدوا الله توابا رحيما يا الله جينا على أبواب أعتاب حبيبك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم يا سيدي يا رسول الله نحن على أعتابك ونحن نقر ونعترف بأننا عاصين ظالمين لأنفسنا ظالمين لغيرنا يا الله ونحن هنا نستغفر الله استغفر 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 الله أستغفر 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 الله من كل ذنب ومعصية من كل ما يخالف دين الإسلام كل ما يخالف الشريعة من كل ما يخالف الطريقة من كل ما يخالف الحقيقة يا ربي بجاه حبيبك المصطفى ونبيك المرتضى لا تدع لنا ذنبا إلا غفرته ولا ضالا إلا هديته ولا عائلا إلا أغنيته ولا مريضا إلا شفيته ولا حاجة من حوائج الدنيا والآخرة إلا قضيتها ويسرتها يا من يجيب الورى من بعد ما قنت يا أرحم الراحمين يا أمان الخائفين يا أمان الخائفين يا شافي يا كافي يا معافي يا ربنا ورب آبائنا الأولين يا الله تبنا ورجعنا إليك لا من جمينك إلا إليك يا ربي اللهم بجاه هذه الصلوات وهذه القصائد وهذه الأذكار أن تغفر لنا ذنوبنا تجعلنا لآلائك ذاكرين ولنعمائك شاكرين وليوم لقائك من الذاكرين وأن تحينا بطاعتك مشغولين وإذا توفيتنا وأن لا تتوفنا إلا مسلمين مؤمنين تائبين عابدين قانتين لربنا مطيعين يا رب العالمين يا رب تعلم ما في أنفسنا ونحن لا نعلم ما في نفسك وأنت علام الغيوب هذا ذلنا ظاهر بين يديك وحالنا لا يخفى عليك أمرتنا فتركنا ونهيتنا فارتكبنا ولا يسعنا إلا عفوك فاعف عنا يا خير مأمول ويا أكرم مسؤول واجزي عنا نبينا خير ما جزيت نبيا عن أمتي اللهم اجعلنا خالصين مخلصين لك يا رب من عبادك المخلصين يا الله يا الله يا الله يا ربي don't leave anyone who came to this gathering or wanted to come, or Ummat al-Habib, except inshallah you grant them for the sake of Salawat on Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, for the sake of your Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, grant them Shifa if they are sick, grant them relief if they are in difficulty, grant them Ghina if they are Fuqara, Ya Allah, you see this condition we are in, we are not complaining. Are accepting, Ya Rabbi. Grant us tawfiq to be patient and to accept your qada. La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah al-aliyyil azim. وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون سلام على المرسلين الحمد لله رب العالمين الفاتحة Alhamdulillah. Thank you very much for joining us. Allah bless you all, inshallah. Alhamdulillah.
I'm sorry.
Who is that?
I am at work. That's why I have to be in a weird way.
No,
astaghfirullah. I'm sorry, assalamualaikum.
Wa alaikum salam. No, you keep your, keep.
I'm at work in my lunch break.
No, you keep your mask on. Now, alhamdulillah, one of the benefits of corona, it's making everybody niqabi.
Alhamdulillah.
It's making... Alhamdulillah, thank you so much, inshallah. Yeah, everything okay? We have permission to move on? We are not able to.
Dua from me, Walaikum Assalam, Shaykh Ali. Thank you. Yeah, I stay here. I stay safe. Make dua for me, please.
Always. We made dua, inshallah, for everyone. We're happy, inshallah. These gatherings of Salah al-Nabi also there, inshallah, become Junnah and protection for you, inshallah, and for all those who are attending. And. Inshallah, everything okay. Yesterday I left and I was told that people were asking, so I didn't want to leave too early today.
No, I'm fine. Thank you. Assalamualaikum.
Alaikum salam. Welcome.
Jazakumullahu khairan, Sayyidi.
Astaghfirullah. Wa iyyakum, inshallah. Barakallahu fiqh. Tayyib. Assalamu alaikum. With your permission, inshallah.